I will make an opening statement. Silvio will make an opening statement. We'll have one question from the Americans, one question from the Italians. We're running a little late. We'd like to spend hours answering your questions, but the problem is we've got other matters to work on. First, it's my honor to welcome Silvio Berlusconi back. He is a personal friend. Italy is a great friend of America. America is a great friend of Italy. Prime Minister and I will, of course, be talking about a lot of matters. The most significant matter will be how to keep the peace, how to make the world a peaceful place. I am most grateful that the Prime Minister signed a letter along with other leaders of European countries, which clarified the issue that we're dealing with, and that is that Saddam Hussein is a clear threat to peace. It was a strong statement. It also was a statement of solidarity with the United States, and I appreciated that very much.
Thank you.
I appreciate your friendship. I welcome you back to the Oval Office and look forward to having a long and fruitful discussion.
We are here for a work for a just cause and for everybody, I think. And I'm here with a friend, with a country that is the best friend of my country.
Well, thank you. And your English is very good.
No. I have never the time. We have so much to do in Italy. I have not the time
to
learn better English.
Well, thank you for that kind comment. Ron.
Sir, are you open to giving Saddam a final deadline, and are you willing to let him slip into exile? This is a man who recently said he wants to break the neck of our country.
Yeah. First, let me echo the comments of my national security advisor, who the other day, in commenting about this process, said this is a matter of weeks, not months. In other words, for the sake of peace, this issue must be resolved. Hopefully, it can be done peacefully. Hopefully, the pressure of the free world will convince Mr. Saddam Hussein to relinquish power. And should he choose to leave the country, along with a lot of the other henchmen who have tortured the Iraqi people, we would welcome that, of course. I will tell my friend Silvio that the use of military troops is my last choice, not my first. The commitment of young men and Americans in the battle is a difficult decision because I understand the cost of war. But I also understand the cost of inaction. There's a high price to be paid for the civilized world by not enforcing the opinion of the world, which was for Saddam Hussein to disarm. There's a reason why leaders around the world believe he ought to disarm. There's a reason why the Security Council of the United Nations voted 15-0 to say to Saddam, disarm, and that's because he's dangerous. Would you care to call somebody from the Italian press?
Sì. In Italia, in italiano, se posso dire, ho già detto che noi siamo da sempre gli alleati fedeli agli Stati Uniti d'America e anche in questo caso noi siamo vicini agli Stati Uniti d'America.
In Italy I already said it, I had the opportunity to say that we have always been the faithful allied country of United States, we are close friends of United States also in this case.
Noi crediamo che il mondo abbia il diritto di sapere dove sono finite le armi di distruzione di massa che lo stesso Saddam Hussein ha dichiarato di possedere.
I believe that the world has a right to find out where all the weapons of mass destruction that Saddam Hussein said he had, where they ended up.
Noi temiamo che dopo la serie di terribili attentati che è culminata con l'attentato dell'11 di settembre ci possa essere l'intenzione da parte dei terroristi di provocare una grande strage.
We really fear that after the series of terrorist attacks which culminated with the attacks on September 11, there is in the intention of the terrorist is to really come to a terrible disaster.
Questo disastro, questa strage, per essere provocata richiede le armi biologiche, le armi chimiche che sono nella disponibilità, che erano nella disponibilità dell'Iraq.
And to do so, they have to avail themselves of the biological, chemical weapons that we know were available at Saddam Hussein.
E quindi, secondo quanto deciso dal Consiglio di sicurezza nella risoluzione 1441, Saddam Hussein deve dimostrare agli ispettori delle Nazioni Unite dove sono finite le armi che l'Iraq possedeva.
Therefore, on the basis of the United Nations Security Council Resolution 1441, Saddam Hussein has to reveal and account for the weapons that we know he has.
Quindi è lui che ha nelle mani la decisione sulla pace, che noi vogliamo, tutti noi vogliamo la pace.
So the decision on peace rests in his hands. We all want peace.
E comunque io sono qui per dare una mano al presidente Bush per convincere tutti che questo è l'interesse di tutti.
And I'm here today to help my friend President Bush to convince everybody that this is in the interest of everybody.
E soltanto se noi saremo tutti uniti, l'Europa, l'Unione Europea, la Federazione Russa e gli Stati Uniti e tutti gli altri stati attraverso il Consiglio di sicurezza delle Nazioni Unite, Saddam capirà che non ha altra scelta che quella di dimostrare la sua reale volontà di distruggere queste armi.
And if we are all united, the European Union, United States, the Federation of Russia, everybody, all the other states under the United Nations, then Saddam Hussein will understand that he will have no other option but to reveal the arms and to destroy them.
Along those lines, let me make one clarification on my statement. I think that no matter how Mr. Saddam is dealt with, the goal of disarming Iraq still stays the same, regardless of who is in charge of the government. And that's very important for the Iraqi people to know. And I also want to assure Silvio that should we require military action shortly after our troops go in, we'll go food and medicine and supplies to the Iraqi people. We will, of course, win militarily if we have to. But we'll also want to make sure that we win the peace as well. Would you like care to call on somebody in the Italian press?
Mr. Prime Minister, I just had a question. You expressed your sentiment of friendship for the United States and loyalty. Now, will you be ready to commit Italy to go along with the United States should the United States put together a coalition with it, as the President has said?
Noi non lasceremo.
Sì. I would have answered it, but they said no. Well, I don't even know the question. Go ahead.
Noi non dimentichiamo mai, nessun giorno mai, che dobbiamo la nostra libertà, la nostra democrazia, il nostro benessere agli Stati Uniti d'America.
We will never forget that we owe our freedom, our wealth to
our
the United States of America and our democracy.
E non dimentichiamo mai che sono state tante le giovani vite americane che hanno pagato col loro sacrificio la nostra libertà e il nostro benessere.
And we also will never forget that there have been many American young lives that have been lost and sacrificed themselves for us.
E quindi per noi gli Stati Uniti sono non soltanto un paese amico, ma sono la garanzia della nostra democrazia e della nostra libertà.
So for us the United States is not only our friend, but they are the guarantee of our democracy and our freedom.
E io ho già detto altra volta al presidente Bush che quando io vedo la bandiera degli Stati Uniti non penso soltanto che sia la bandiera di una nazione, ma penso che sia il simbolo della libertà e della democrazia nel mondo intero.
And I already had the opportunity to say this to President Bush. Every time I see the US flag, I don't see the flag only representative of a country, but I see it as a symbol of democracy and of freedom. Thank you, sir.
Thank you all very much. Lights.
Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you.